Don't take permanent decisions based on temporary feelings. When you're feeling sad, you feel you get into drugs. You know why the hell are you getting into drugs? The reason is you want a short-term escape route, and that's where you are selling yourself unto a most clutches where you can't even come back. Let emotions subside, let feelings go as they like, but don't be dictated by them. Don't take a permanent decision based on a short-term feeling which subsides, which goes away. And Bible says weeping may be in the night and joy comes in the morning. Feelings are always temporary. Mark these words, and don't take a permanent decision based on feelings. Don't take permanent decisions based on temporary feelings. I think hope you got me. I don't go by feelings, I go by the word of God. Because if you succumb to feelings, Satan can play with you. Enemy can play somersault with you. It is written, I go by the word of God. Man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God. My dear brother and sister, don't be swayed by feelings. Know the feelings, understand that they are feelings, understand that feelings are temporary, and don't be dictated by these short-term feelings, and don't let your permanent decisions be based upon the temporary feeling. That's why when you're feeling angry, you throw at others. You know, our situation becomes so hot that, you know, you people start hating each other. Life becomes hell here. And you are feeling sad. You don't want to work. 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 And finally, your work is put at stake. You are boosted off from your job. And then you say, Lord, why did you allow this thing? I am fired from my job. As a depressed person, I can't take you, your boss says. And you can't even work. What's the reason? Just because I'm not feeling like working, I don't feel like working. What is that? Never let the temporary emotions dictate your behavior, nor your future, nor your faith, nor your journey of ministry. That's why many times, if you want to do great things for the Lord, let us take the example of Jesus Christ. He didn't let the feelings dictate his ministry nor his focus. That's why don't let the feelings dictate your future and your destiny. That's why word of God says in Genesis chapter 25 verse 32, when Esau was feeling hungry, you know what did he do? Esau said, behold, I am at the point to die, and what profit shall it be? The birthright to do to me, take this birthright and let me sell you off just for the feeling, to change the feeling. He sold his birthright. You know why? Even today, when you're feeling sad, you feel you get into drugs. You know why the hell are you getting into drugs? The reason is you want a short-term escape route, and that's where you are selling yourself unto a most clutches where you can't even come back. Why do you start smoking? Why do you start drinking? You know, why do you get into addictions? The reason is the short feelings which are disturbing you. You want to take an escape route and you want to spoil your life forever and ever. Suicidal thoughts. When you go through depression, you know, you feel like committing suicide. I am telling you, my dear brother and sister, these thoughts may come at any moment. Don't let the short-term emotions, feelings dictate long-term decisions. That's why someone said something like this: suicide is a permanent solution for a temporary problem. You take a permanent decision just because you're not able to take it any longer. Once again, I'm requesting everyone who is watching this in the name of the Lord, don't do that mistake. Let emotions subside, let feelings go as they like, but don't be dictated by them. Don't take a permanent decision based on a short-term feeling which subsides, which goes away. And Bible says weeping may be in the night and joy comes in the morning. God himself said emotions are short-lived. You see the scriptural pages everywhere. Weeping or sadness may come in the night, but joy comes in the morning. You know what Jesus Christ, Bible says it very clearly in Ecclesiastes, that he has sandwiched the happiness and sadness. He has sandwiched the joy and the pain. He has sandwiched the enjoyment and suffering. Together he sandwiched so that men would not boast against God. Feelings are always temporary. Mark these words, and don't take a permanent decision based on feelings. Suddenly, you know, you say, I want to go for divorce. Why? I'm not feeling well. I don't like this. I hate this man. I hate this woman. I want to apply for divorce. Why? I have a feeling that I don't like him. I have a feeling that I don't like her. I have a feeling that I can't adjust. So what? Shall we apply for divorce? Or once the lockdown is lifted up, shall we apply directly to high court? And I want to... Where are you heading for just a temporary feeling? You are taking a permanent decision of splitting the relationships. You say that you are a best friend. Next moment you say that I don't like you. I hate you. Don't show your face. Just because of feeling, I don't want to show your face permanently. I make a permanent decision just because of a short-term emotion or a feeling. Because of a one word you hurt me or I hurt you, immediately you say that, therefore I don't want to see your face forever and ever. Never show your face to me. Where are you? What are you doing? Emotions keep changing, and where the hell are you heading towards just because of a short-term emotion? You say that, you know, just because father hurt you, therefore I don't want to see the face of the father. Mother hurt me, therefore I don't want to see the face of the mother. Mother-in-law hurt me, therefore I don't want to see her face. Daughter-in-law hurt me, I don't want to see her face. Just because of a temporary feeling, you want to take a permanent decision and call splits. Is it not unscriptural? What is truth, and truth will set you free? Where are you taking a costly decision just because of a temporary emotion? That's why Bible says suicidal ideations God is condemning once again. Bible says Jesus Christ has come into this world to give life and to give it abundantly. And the very reason the life temple was formed is for this, that everyone should enjoy the abundance of life. It is not just the life alone. Even during this lockdown, even during this pandemic, you have to enjoy the fullness of life, and abundance of life is through Lord Jesus Christ. Don't let your feelings dictate your destiny, my dear brother and sister. Once again, I request you in the name of the Lord.